Hello everybody, my name is Ellen. Welcome to my living room. I'm really glad to have you here and I hope today I can show you something that works really, really good for me and it might also help you in the future. I don't know if you're dealing with anxiety or depressions, if you have a really stressful job where a lot of things are going on and are bothering you from time to time. If it's just when you're at home, what I gotta show you today is adaptable for every situation. You can do it anywhere and it helps immediately. You only have to prepare it and have it handy. What I'm talking about is a principle you learn in behavioral therapy, and it's used for borderliners, for people dealing with depression and a lot of other situations. And I also used it in my coachings when it was about self-love or self-organization. And I also used it in coachings for customer service because it's something that takes a little bit of effort. It does, but you do it once and you can use it very long and very often till you have to redo it or before you have to redo it. In the behavioral therapy, the thing is called emergency box or emergency bag. That sounds really dramatic, but that's not what it really is. We are talking about some items you can have handy. You can have them in your desk, you can have them in your purse. And it's just about having things handy that help you instantly. Because let's talk about the situation. You're in the office, the phone's ringing all the time, people are coming, emails are stacking up, and it gets more and more and more, and you feel it's getting too much. Everybody has several their own symptoms. I often feel that it's getting harder to breathe for myself. I almost hear my blood pounding, but that's a really high stress level. Or it's just that you start to feel uncomfortable and the need of relief. Sometimes it just helps to get up and walk a couple of steps, maybe just climbing the stairs up and down for one or two stores. Maybe you can walk around the building. But maybe you cannot leave your desk for one reason or another, and then it's helpful to have this emergency bag handy. And you don't need to wait till it's really, I can't stand it anymore. You can use it even earlier to lower the level of tension you're feeling. And as I said, you can have it in a box. When I'm working, I have one of these small pouches where I have my things in I need. All right, here I prepared a little box where I have the stuff in I want to show you. The thing is, you have to find your own mix. You have to find your own emergency box. The variations are endless. I will show you some, but maybe you can think about even more. Or if you want to, I can send you a list with suggestions. Just contact me by email or in the comments, and I will also post a small list in the description of this video. So let's start. And as I said, it's really it makes sense to prepare these things ahead, because the higher the tension is, the less more creative you are and the less more sense you have. So let's start with the easiest thing. I have a mint plant here. Of course, it's not usually on my desk. It's out on the balcony. But when I am at home and have a stressful situation, I have several herbs outside. So sometimes it's just to take the plant and rub the hands in it, stick the face in, or just take the scent. Put it in your hands and inhale it and just Let it sink through your body, so to say. Enjoy the fragrant and take a few breaths, and just you will feel the breathing alone will help a lot, and even the breathing will take you down. You can prepare yourself a YouTube list, and I would refer several YouTube lists. You can add a list with breathing exercises. I always had a list with cat and baby videos because I didn't want to start looking for them when I was in the situation. So I have this list ready on YouTube and I just click play. And as I said, cat videos work wonders. I don't know why. I'm not even a cat person, but I love cat videos or videos with little babies doing funny things, something like this, just for 1 or 2 minutes. Just having a laugh or even having a grin or a smile lets a lot of the stress and the tension get lost. It really helps to just to laugh about it, and the mimic of laughing alone changes the state you are in. The mind has another option. When you are in the office, you won't have a mind. And what definitely belongs into your emergency box is a smell. Which smell you find soothing and comforting is your decision. So you just can take your mint plant and put 1 or 2 branches in a plastic bag. You can buy those bags, but you very often have them coming with something. When I have my paintings, I have wooden chips in those bags. They are a little bit smaller. And I said, you buy some of them, they are not really expensive. You can also use some small jars. It's just important that you can really close them tightly, have them in your bag, and when you need them, you just open them and inhale out of the box and out of the bag. And if you do it with the bag, that has another average, because you don't inhale too much oxygen, what would make you dizzy. So breathing in and out of the bag is a really good thing. You can use these bags also for coffee. You can put in some coffee beans or just a coffee pad. I have here some dried lavender from my lavender bush last year. You can put them in, and when you think it doesn't smell anymore, just rub it a little bit and you can exchange it at any time. It's just the smelling and the breathing is the thing that works fastest. Or if you don't like a comforting taste, if you need something more aggressive that really snaps you out, I have this tiger balm. You can buy it in every drugstore. It's a really intense Asian mint paste, and it's really, it goes up in your brain. It feels like a poking your brain. It's like when you smell raw horseradish. It's really intense. It's a small thing. It's about 1 or 2 euros, and you can have one in each of your bags. It's really no big deal. It also helps when you have a headache. You just rub a little bit on side your eyes or under your nose, and it really helps you just by inhaling. It also has a light cooling effect, but be careful not to put it in your eyes because it's burning like hell. The next sense we serve can be taste. So I have here some mint sweets, and I also have some chocolate and wafers in my bag. I extra take this bag because I don't want a big bag carrying around. So I have several of those in several bags, and I said here it's just 3 or 4, because it's not about eating, it's just about having something in your mouth. And it's really good if you have something with texture. I just showed these are covered with sugar, and in the beginning they are really hard, and when you have them in your mouth they get smoother. And those have nuts around them. And then there's a wafer, so you have one item and you have several consistencies and several haptics. And this is really important because it's about focusing on the small things, so to say. Like before, you focused on the scent, and now it's about what you're feeling in your mouth. It's not chewing, it's just about exploring it, finding out what it is. The edgy sugar, or first the feeling of the nuts and the scent and taste of the nuts, then you bite through it and you have the wafer, and then there's a kind of chocolate cream inside. So you can really focus on the sensation of eating this. And it's something that's really that not all your colleagues see what you are doing. They might be used that you are having a piece of chocolate or a cookie at times. So this is really undercover, and nobody knows that you are actually doing a kind of therapy or treating yourself against stress. You're just enjoying your chocolate and the chewing and the feeling of the nuts and the wafer and the chocolate cream. And focusing on this is actually, it's a kind of awareness practice, and it just drags you out of your situation and gives you something to focus in, to focus on. And we have other things that can be more or less visible. These are my best friends. I have them in several sizes, and it really helps you. You can use it as a stress ball. You can really give all your anger and your tension in them, but you can also just play with those spikes and have your fingers on it turning around. And it's another sensation you have. You can have it, as I said, covered. You can just work on it while you're on the telephone. And some people may get annoyed when you do it all the time, but for instant stress relief, they are really, really good. And the same is with bracelets. This one has the average that you can play with the little pearls. You can let it run through your fingers. Also something you can even do under the table and nobody will see it. You can have a rubber band like this, and a lot of people let it just snip when they are tense. Actually, that's another thing a lot of borderliners get used to. It's also just a stress relief, and this little snitching pain also distracts you from your tension and helps you to get out of this mood. There are, of course, some nicer and smoother things when you don't need this harsh impact. Stones. This one is glass, and this one is an actual rose quartz. I just choose this rose quartz first. A rose quartz is known to be soothing and even out, level the emotions a little bit, but I also take it because of the shape, because it's really comforting to rub it with the thumb and feeling the texture. It has some rough edges and some smoother jobs, some smoother edges and corners. And you can have it in your hand, you can play around with it, you can even look at it and follow the small crackles and the several crystals and breaks that are inside. It's also two sensations. You can feel it. You also can give some pressure in it without somebody seeing it. If it has a sharp edge and you need this peaking feeling, this strong feeling, you just can push this edge in your hand, in your finger. But please be careful that you don't cut yourself. That's not what we want. We just want a little intense sensation, or as I said, just the rubbing and giving some of the energy in the rubbing. And this is a glass chip. It's the same. It really has the fitting size for my thumb. I have them in my jeans when I'm at work. I also have several of them. I can even have them open on my table. Nobody knows what it's for. And we have the same thing. We can look at it, we can watch it. As it's glass, you can even see through it and change the perspective in more than one reason. And it's really good for rubbing. It has a banded and a flat side. So again, you have several sensations you feel while you're doing it. And as I said, it fits in the small bags. The next thing, I forgot about the scent. As I said, you can do your dried lavender, your coffee, your mint leaves, what you want, or you can make have a little spray. You can use your favorite perfume. If you have a small bottle, you can fill it in. This is a small for the handbag. You can refill. I bought it at a drugstore for about 2 euros, and you don't have this much in it. And I have my own mix, or make my own mix. I use rose water, lemon zest, and some other things. And I just refill it, and I spray it in the air, or I spray it on a handkerchief, a piece of fabric, or I even spray it in one of those plastic bags, because there's nothing poison, there's no poison in it, there's no gas in it, it's just a pure scent. And when you have your favorite scent in there, you have a mix, something different to the herbs you may have with you, or the strong scent of the tiger balm. You can here have something really smoothing. And there are tons of recipes what you can mix. You can use it almost every day in your office. You just spray it around your desk. It makes you feel a little bit fresh. You can also take it outside and use it on the stairs if you don't want to bother your colleagues. If you want something uplifting, I always have some, so to say, funny postcards or pictures. Usually I have them in a special file on my cell phone, because carrying postcards around is a little bit much for me. But you can also have a kind of a diary or something where you put pictures from people that lift you up, or places where you have been, some memories. Just something you can have in your hand and focus on, and go into the memory, remember the situations, and just enjoy or recall the experience you had. Pardon me. And what I also like to do, but that's a favorite thing of mine, sometimes I have to feel I have to destroy something I really want to demolish. I'm angry about a person, a customer is really trampling on my nerves. What I then do is just I take a piece of paper out of the trash bin and I rip it. And I rip it really carefully and thoughtful in really small stripes, as long as possible. Sometimes I can make it to rip one sheet of paper in one piece. And it's really satisfying for me to hear the noise of the ripping paper, and seeing the spiral getting longer and longer. That's something where you really can put your aggressions in without ripping off somebody's head. What you might prefer in this situation, but in the end, that won't get you anywhere. So it might be better to rip some paper. If you can get any paper, take a napkin, kitchen towel, whatsoever. Even that's a thing that, well, people might see that you're a little bit aggressive, but you can also do it really smooth and slowly, even while you're on the phone, and it won't jump in people's eyes or mind what you're actually doing. And it's really, as I said, I feel it's very satisfying and relieving. Of course, it's my pleasure. I do nothing, I love nothing more than giving you whatever you want. You're so right, sir. Of course, sir. And it's getting longer and longer. Or another thing that's a little more nice and creative, I'm scribbling. And it's really sometimes I'm really just doing some lines to get out of the tension. And sometimes I just let the pen run over the paper and to do some circles and lines. And the more tense I am, the more anxiety I feel, the more detailed those scribblings get. So I'm just giving you an example what you can do easily without being an artist and without having a really creative bone. It's just, you see, you do the circles and then you draw some lines into the circles. You can do it with one pen, one color, whatever you have in hand. It's just about getting focused in details, because if you focus on details, it's much easier, even automatically, that you withdraw out of your environment, you withdraw from all the menace and the chaos around you, and you go really in this small detailed thing. It doesn't take you hours. It's not necessary that it's a piece of art. It's really about just going in detail in really petite, in tiny things. And that really helps you a lot. And then I have one secret weapon I love at home, because in the office it's not that nice to do this. I'm pretty sure you know these things. In Germany, we call them head spiders or head massager. Just you put them on the back of your head, and oh, I really love them. And I think they are really, really relaxing. And they don't hurt. And it's a really nice thing to have to get rid of the tension. When you're at home, I would suggest when you come out of a stressful day or stressful situation that you take a shower or bath, and at the end of it, you take some salt and just rub your skin with the salt gently. And so you can imagine to exfoliate the bad energies and the bad experiences of your skin. You rub off the negative energy, and then you watch this negative energy disappear through the sink with the bath water. So you don't only wash up the sweat, you literally wash and scrub off the day and the negativity. And it's very good for the blood flow in the skin. It exfoliates dead skin, so you feel better and refreshed after it. And you also have this symbolic rubbing up of the negative energy and pouring it out of the drain. And that's pretty much it. And as I said, you take whatever you need for yourself. I have this small bag, I have my stone, I have my necklace, my tiger balm, my mint, and let's say this little darling here. And that's really not much. And you have a lot of things you can do. And then your playlist, you may have some music, some nice short videos, maybe some breathing exercises. You prepare all of this, and when you feel the need, when you feel the tension rising, then all you have to do is taking your bag or taking your little box, open the drawer of your desk, put on your your headphones, let a playlist roll, or inhale your mint, matcha your little stress ball, whatsoever. So you have a variety of things. You don't even have to think. You just press play. You just open your zipper, take something out, and if this doesn't work, you have this and that. You just have a variety of things you can do. In this moment, don't even think about it. Just grab one thing, and if it doesn't feel right, take the next one. But prepare it in time. Prepare it before you are in stress, because when you are in stress, you're not in the mood to run around and look for a mint bush. That won't work. And I really invite you to find your own tools, to find your own method, what brings you down, things you can include into your workspace, in your private area. And all of this you can even use in the bus or when you are shopping and it gets too tight and too tense. You can use all of them almost anywhere at any time, and I can almost promise you that it will help instantly. At least for me, it worked, and it still does, because as you see, I have all my stuff handy. So have fun and enjoy gathering your playlists, preparing your little emergency kit. I'm pretty sure you will have a lot of fun even collecting these things, putting out some old pictures, recalling the old memories. You will enjoy collecting and gathering it as much as you will enjoy the relief you will feel when you really need and use in the end your emergency kit. I wish you days without any negative tensions, a lot of fun and relaxations. Have a nice day, darlings.